Hello, it's Anna Kimani. I'm back again for another session as we continue, or as I continue exploring on this important topic and on what parents and guardians, what you could do to support the young people who are under your care and going through education or schooling. And to you young people, what you could do to get the best out of your education or schooling, because as I have reminded you again and again, you spend a lot of your young age going through education, all the way from very young age to the age of 18 years, which is a compulsory age to go through education in almost all countries, and actually it should be to all countries across the whole world. And also we said we can't leave out the ages 18 to 24 because they also need a lot of support. I've covered several topics looking at different areas on education. And today, I'll be looking at the very young children. I've received a lot of requests from parents and guardians who have got small children, and they have asked me to share my expertise on how to support the very young children that they have got at home or going through education. And that's what I'll be covering today. And although I've said that I'll be looking at the very young children, the video will also be very good for children in lower primary, upper primary, and even lower secondary school. So if you're a parent with a child under that age, it's good also to bring the child with you, listen together. And if you know of another parent who have got young children at home and also going to school, please share the video with them so that they can also benefit from it. Again, reminding you, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, Anna G. Kimani, please consider subscribing so that you can get updates and notifications as I upload new videos in the coming future. Again, once you subscribe, you'll be able to go back and watch all the other videos that I have uploaded, whether you're a parent or guardian, or whether you're a student yourself. Again, follow me on my Facebook page, Excellence in Education Progress. My Facebook page is Excellence in Education Progress. Follow me, like it, and I'm sharing a lot of resources there and you'll benefit as well. Again, now I have got a website which is live. I've shared a lot of resources there as well. So consider checking it out. My website is AnnaGKimaniPublications.com. My website again is AnnaGKimaniPublications.com. Okay, so today I said we are looking at the very young children, and actually when it's come to education and when it's come to the working ethos of the students, they work well when it has been introduced from a very young age, and as they grow up, they're able to build up that working ethos or ethos as they continue with their education. So, mainly when it comes to the working with very young children, because I'm addressing parents and guardians and students across the whole world globally, it depends on the languages spoken in those countries, but we shall be looking at how it can benefit all the parents and guardians and students from whichever part of the world you're coming from as a parent or guardian or as a student. So if I address it from, let's say, English part of it, today I shall be looking at reading and writing, how to support the child under your care on reading and writing, and in English we call it the literacy. I'll be covering that today, and depending on your country, whatever you call it, when it comes to reading and writing, listen, and then you're going to benefit as well. In another session, and in the next video that I'll be uploading, I'll be looking at the numeracy or maths, and how, if you have got a young child under your care going through education, right from very young age, how you could support them with numeracy or with maths. That is for another video when it's come to the numeracy or maths, but for today we shall be looking at reading and writing, and I said in English we call it literacy, depending on the language that you're following in your country. But we shall be looking at reading and writing today. So, it is good to introduce reading to a child when they are very young. Introduce reading to a child when they are very young. And I'm going to support myself with what I've written in my book. I'll be introducing my book to you. I have introduced my book before, and also from other experts. And I'm going to read a quote on when you should introduce your child to reading, because reading is supposed to be introduced at very young age, as young as 3 months. I know that may look quite surprising to many, but reading should start at very young age, as young as 3 months. And to remind you that when it's come to reading to the young children, it should be fun. It should be done out of fun. They need to enjoy it. It should be fun. And I was looking at on the website. There's a company here known as, their website is Grow by Web MD. Grow by Web MD. And this is what I found out. Before babies learn to talk in a real language, whether it is English, German, French, Spanish, their vernacular languages, their dialect, any language, they babble and coo, playing with sounds. That's baby talk. And baby talk sounds similar the world over. So you find that when the children are very young, from whichever part of the world, when they start babbling their first words, they'll babble the same words from whichever part of the world they are coming from. Baby talk at 3 months. At 3 months, your baby listens to your voice, watches your face as you talk, and turns towards other voices, sounds, and music that can be heard around home. Many also prefer voices and music be heard while they were still in the womb. So, as a pregnant mom, just get to know that the baby can hear when they're even in the womb. So it's good to talk to them positive things, to address positive things. And that's why I'm saying it is very good to create conducive environment at home. Home should have peaceful environment, because from this expert here, the baby can hear sounds and voices, even music, even in the womb. So it's important to have conducive home environment, even during pregnancy, and as the babies are born, as they grow up, as they go through education. By the end of 3 months, baby begins cooing, a happy, gentle, repetitive sing-song vocalization. Okay, so we see when it's come to reading, they need to be introduced quite early, and because baby can listen from very young age. I'm also going to read from another expert. This is from Penguin, or other experts from Penguin, penguin.co.uk. And this is what they have said when it's come to when to introduce reading to the young children. The best time to start reading books to young baby is from 3 to 6 months, or once they are able to focus on items such as a mirror or a toy. As your baby begins to enjoy the rhythm and flow of the day, from feeding to sleeping, try to make reading books with your child an integral part of their daily life too. As they grow, create a small reading area in your house with a range of books in a basket and comfy cushions. As your baby begins to crawl, they will be curious to explore the books in the area. Talk to your baby at key times, for example, while feeding or dressing them. Describe what you're both doing, such as, "I'm going to put on your first now." So, you see, it's important to start talking to the babies when they are small, when they start focusing, etc. Introducing them to the reading. But I said reading is fun. It should be fun. The same from Penguin that I found out, one of the most important skills your child will learn in life is being able to read. And most importantly, reading for pleasure, for fun. Reading play a major role in communication, linking to listening, speaking and writing, and it also stimulates creativity. So that is from penguin.co.uk. You can check it out. So when you start introducing your child, we have seen this from the 3 months as they grow up, and especially as they come to the age of, let's say, 6 months, they grow to 9 months. It's also good to read with them. Introduce the picture books, very big books, picture books, look around with them. And then as they grow, it's good to tell them, speak the word, book, dog. Tell them, try to mention the names of the pictures that you can see from that book. And introduce it from home as a parent and guardian. And as they grow up, you need to check from your community whether they have got toddler crabs. Toddler crabs where parents and guardians from that community who have got young babies or toddlers come and meet, and the babies are able to interact. And also as a parent and guardian, you will meet other like-minded parents and guardians who bring their children, and you can share. And also the babies will start interacting. So if there is no toddler crab in where you're coming from, be the pioneer. Start it as a parent or guardian. If there's no toddler crab where you're coming from, then be the pioneer and start it. You can start meeting in a centralized area. They could be maybe in a local community hall, or if there are some religious centers where you're coming from, you can request them to give you a room where you can start and pioneer the toddler crab. And then the parent or guardians from that community can be able to be meeting at least once a week, maybe for 1 hour, and interact. And the babies, the young children, the toddlers are able to meet up as well, meet other children of their age and interact and have time to play around. There'll be books there, big books with pictures to look around. There'll be toys, etc. Okay, so toddler club or a play group in the community. They need to be started even before the children or the babies, these toddlers start going to school. If they can start with a toddler club or a play group in the community. And again, because I'm addressing the whole world or globally, depending on where people are coming from or from which part of the world people are coming from, if you are listening to me and you have got this knowledge, you are literate enough, you have got the skills, look back into your community and check whether this facility of toddler club, check whether it is available. If it's not available, then look into how you can support the parents and guardians from that community or from that society to have it started. Be the pioneer Even if you have grown up there, God has helped you to grow up. Maybe even those who are coming from very remote parts of the world. If God has helped you and you have managed to go through, maybe you have moved maybe to settle for work, business. It's good to go back to your local community, your roots, and see whether these facilities are there and see how the parents from those communities or societies can be helped to start these toddlers club or these prayer groups so that the parents and guardians can have access to them and they can be meeting even if it's once a week for 1 hour and bring the children, bring the toddlers, the very young children so that they can have time together. Okay. Continue. And we find that as the child start exploring the books from very young age, as you talk to the children from very young age, then they start developing vocabularies and they start understanding the language. And again, I said that it depends with the language, depending on which country one is coming from, the languages which are spoken there. And in another video, I said it's very important for students or for the young people to have more than two languages that they can fluently speak and write. If it is the children or young people who are coming from backgrounds or from countries which has got vernacular languages or their local dialect, and then they have got the national language spoken in that country, they need to be very fluent in speaking and writing those languages from their country, the vernacular, the dialect, and also the national language. And also it is good to have another language that they can communicate with when it's come to the international community. Whether it is Spanish, Dutch, German, English, French, Portuguese, Italian, there are many languages that are spoken across the whole world. And depending on the country you're coming from, for a child to be fluent in a second language, especially a modern language, it's good to start it early. It's good to be introduced early. Modern languages can be learned later in life, but when it is introduced early enough, it is important. And I was looking at another expert, what they have said when it comes to introducing a second language to a child, let's say another modern language from the language they have grown up with or is spoken with the locality. And this is what they said, and I got this from the University of Washington Institute for Learning and Brain Sciences. And this is what they have said. Standards suggest that optimal learning is achieved when children start learning two languages at an early age, between birth and 3 years of age, through high quality interactions with the right human beings, and both languages are supported throughout toddler, preschool, and school years. Okay. And I also looked at another website on why it is important to introduce the second language at a very young age to a child so that they are fluent in reading and in writing. And this is, I got this from a website, www.parent.com. The website again is www.parent.com, and this is what they have said. Every infant is born with the ability to mimic the sound of any language. But by the time a baby is about 10 months old, he begins to narrow down the range of sounds to those that he hears around him. So if you want your child to learn a second language, it is best to introduce it in the first year of life. So it needs to be introduced quite early, the second language, depending on where the children are coming from, where the children are born. So going back to how to support the young, very young children through their reading and writing. And as I said, in English, we call it literacy, but it depends on the country you're coming from. You need to check out what you call it. But when we when we emphasize now, if I emphasize on reading and writing, what are the benefits of reading for the child? And I'm going to give it from my book. I've introduced this book before, It's Parents and Guardians, How You Can Support Your Children Through Education. To your students, learn how to push those grades up, maximizing your child's educational potential, by Anna Kimani. It is me who has written this book, and there's a whole section on how to support young children, both in reading and writing, which is literacy, and also in numeracy, which is maths. So what's the importance of how do the children benefit when they get introduced to reading early enough? And one of the benefits is, I'll read one, is pick new words and vocabulary naturally. They start picking new words and vocabulary naturally. Two, develop creative imaginations. Three, looking for different ways to solve problems. Four, easiest way to gain knowledge. Five, help in uncovering one's interest. Six, and as people get older, they become lazy in reading, but if one has developed the habit of reading while young, they tend to carry on with reading. So those are six important benefits of introducing reading to a child when they're still very young. And let's now look as the child grows, as the child is developing, depending, you know, you have introduced reading from very young age. We from one of the experts to say that even babies, when they're in the womb, they can hear the voices of the people in the home, especially the mom. They can hear music as they grow. When they start focusing, right from the age of 3 months, you can start introducing big picture books going through. And then as they grow, after reading, as they grow, you need to start introducing other things. You learn this when you go to the toddler clubs, and especially if you can get an expert to be talking to you about it on the child development, that will be very helpful. But as they develop, you need to introduce writing. We are looking at reading and writing, how as a parent with young children, how you could support them with reading and writing or literacy, or what you call it back in your country. So from my own experience with my own children, I have done that right from very young age. And then when they start school, now I start introducing writing, supporting them home. Okay, they are getting it at school. Okay, they go through playgroup, nursery, they come to reception, depending on the curriculum that is followed in your country, depending on the age of the child. So maybe when they get to year one, for me, what I did as they started the foundation or the Roa School, which is key stage one in the United Kingdom, and to be specific in England, they are working at school, they are reading a lot at school as well. But even before I come to introducing the writing, if I could go back where we said about as the toddler clubs and also the pre-group clubs in the community, where the parents come together and take their children, even if it's once a week, even for 1 hour. As a parent and guardian, it's also important that you visit the library with your young child, and borrow books from the local library. And also the young children at school, they'll be given books from the school library. Also, visit the book fair, check whether there are book fairs going on around you. And you can buy new books or even old books from those book fair. And again, I know I'm doing this session when there is this COVID-19 and there are restrictions. on how to interact or mix up with other people, depending on the country you're coming from. And again, it's good to be very careful because every government is trying to avoid the rate of infection. But we are not going to be under COVID restriction forever. So I'm going to address this video, or I'm addressing this video on what you could do if there was no COVID, because COVID will come to an end. But what you can be doing as parent yourself, or a guardian supporting the young people, and how you can join up with like-minded parents in your community, even as the children get support from school. Okay. So, visit the library, local libraries, school library, encourage your children to get book from school. They are reading at school, but borrow book from the school library, book fair, buy old books, new books, etc. And also as a parent or guardian, as you go shopping, if you find good books on the bookshelves, bookshops, wherever you go, buy them. They don't have to be very expensive, as long as they are appropriate for the young people, as young children, especially the books with pictures, big books with big pictures, so that you can read through and they're exploring. And again, depending on where you're coming from, if there are no local libraries, or if the school that your child is attending doesn't have these facilities of school libraries or storybooks to borrow, again, I would encourage you to be the pioneer of starting library books club, where you encourage parents to buy books or look for books, and then they can share within the community. And again, if you are listening to me and you have got the knowledge or the understanding and the skills, it's good to go back to your community, go back to your roots, and support the parents and guardians there. Talk to the local government or other people in leadership who are in charge in their area, and see how you could help these parents and guardians to start at least a book club where they can be borrowing books and helping their children in reading. It's important. So coming back now to introducing writing as a child is growing, what you need to do is encourage as a child is growing, maybe at the age from the age of 6-7, and as I said, everything needs to be fun. Don't stress up the children. It needs to be fun, but they need to be introduced so that they can get a very good foundation when it's come to the education, because they are going through education anyway. And in future, they'll be interacting and meeting other people from all over the world who have gone through education. So they need to be exposed to it as well in very good quality education background in it. So when it comes to introducing the writing at home as a parent and guardian, start by asking the young children about their everyday activity, what they did through the day. Like if it is in the evening, ask them how your day has been. What you can do is you can tell them, get a small book and ask them to journal or write what about their day, what they went through the day, what they did, etc. And in this, when they are young, at times maybe their spelling might not be great, but if you have got the ability, once they have written and you can read as a parent, then mark the work with them, mark whatever they have written. It doesn't have to be a lot, but mark what they have written, or mark what they have journaled, what they have written. And then, even if you don't, as a parent, you don't have the ability to read or to write, encourage your child to sit down and journal what they have about their day. And then once they start it from home, and because they're also doing it at school, it will translate to school, and the teachers will pick it up and help them in correcting the spellings as they are developing their writing skills in school. But you need to support them, and especially during the school holidays, weekends. Yes, the children need to rest. It needs to be fun, But remember, it's good also to help them to develop it as parent and guardian. Okay. Then another way that you could introduce writing is when you borrow the book from the school library or from the local community library or from this community book club. Then when you have read it with them or they have read the book, tell them to analyze the book. Tell them to write about the book. What is the book talking about? Maybe have a chapter or one chapter a day. Go through that book. Tell them you have read this. Write it in your own words what you have learned from this book. Here you're introducing reading and writing. Then start with a small book. If you can mark it, you can go through the work what they have written with them, fine. If not, don't worry about it. As you continue practicing, when they go to school, they'll continue writing, developing their writing skills, and the teacher, their class teacher, will be able to pick it up and correct any spellings. Okay, as they progress, let's say from year 4, let's say at the age of 9, or even age of 8, depending, because children work at different potentials, abilities. We don't want to stress them up. We want them to do everything relaxed and out of fun. They're enjoying it. Then you can introduce the writing structure. The writing structure, the beginning, the middle, and the ending. Or we can say the introduction, the middle, and the conclusion. So whatever they're writing, let them know how to introduce it, how to build it up, and then how to conclude. My young daughter called it the sandwich. It's the top bread, the middle filling, and the bottom part. So the beginning, the middle, where they build up what they're writing, and the conclusion. Let them develop that writing structure. It's important. And also, as they grow up, again, even if you don't know how to look at it, you're not very experienced in this experience or guardian, if you didn't get that education background, you're not literate enough in this, don't worry about it, because your child is attending school and they will continue developing their reading and their writing skills, and they are getting the support from school, and their teachers will be able to pick it up. Okay. Then from there, maybe as they are growing towards their upper primary school or lower high school, then introduce maybe a big size book like A4 and let them now start developing their sentences construction and their paragraph constructions. I always say if it is a paragraph, it should have at least 5 sentences. Short and meaningful sentences. With the time, they'll know how to write in short and meaningful sentences so that they are not repeating themselves. Each sentence talking about a different point. And also when it's come to the paragraph, let them introduce something new in the next paragraph. Okay. Also, we said about SPAG, which is spelling, punctuation, and grammar, which, and especially I say depending on which part of the country you're coming from, right from primary school, secondary, when it's come to England, there is extra marks for spelling, punctuation, and grammar. Apart from what they have written in what they're writing, there is extra mark for spelling, punctuation, and grammar. And especially in my subject, because I said I'm a geography specialist, depending on the number of marks, if it's 8 marks question, it will be 8 marks for that question, and then there will be extra 4 marks for the spelling, punctuation, and grammar. If it is a 12 marks question, it will be the 12 marks for the question plus 4 extra marks for spelling, punctuation, and grammar. That is why it's good to introduce this to children when from very young age as they grow, but in a relaxed and fun way. Let it be fun, because I'm looking at parents and guardians here. what you could do to support your young children going through education. And I know the school is doing its best, but it's also good for the parents and guardians to be involved as well. And I'm going to read from another quote from another author that I quoted from my book. Let me go to that. By the name Lucas B. and Spencer E., 2017, page 12. And this is what the two others have written when it comes to the parent and guardian supporting children going through education. Parents have an important role in supporting the messages teachers convey to runners about running. They can either reinforce the capabilities at home or contradict them. In this respect, the education and involvement of parents is key. So, that's another author who has written. I quoted these two authors in my book when it's come to parents or the guardians supporting the young people who are under their care and going through education. Okay, so as I said, today we're looking at reading and writing, and we have looked at what other experts have said about it. I've shared my expertise in it. And as parent and guardian, remember, as you're supporting the young children, especially those who have started school, right from the ages 3 and above, it's good to keep in touch as well with school, keep in touch with your subject teachers, inquire and ask which other support you could give to your children when you're at home, and they'll be very happy to support you. Ask for additional materials if you need some to support them at home. When it comes to homework, you need to ask, seek for help and for guidance from their subject teachers, from their class teachers. For those who are in primary, the lower secondary school will be the subject teachers, so that they can get better. But remember, it has to be fun, in a relaxed way. Do not stress them about. And remember that important part of making sure that there's the right home environment, the right conducive environment at home for the very young children. I have read from you from another expert that children can hear voices, even music, voices from those around them, and especially the mom, even in the womb. And as they grow, even from the age of 3 months, you can start introducing reading when they start focusing. Of course, it's just going through pictures, you know, pointing as they grow, the picture house. You see, they'll start picking up the language and the vocabularies. And again, I said, it depends on which part of the world you're coming from. And I said, again, I'll repeat here the importance of starting toddler clubs in the community, where the parent can, even before the children start school, the parent can be able to meet with their young children and they'll be able to run together. And also the books club, if you haven't got access to local libraries or school libraries. If there isn't, be the pioneer and start it as a parent and guardian, and support other parents from your community or from your society. So it's Anna Kimani. So today we look at reading and writing for the very young children as they grow up all the way to their lower secondary school. And next lesson or next session, we shall be looking at maths, numeracy, how as parent or guardian you could support the very young children under your care even before they start school, even as they start school at very, very young age, how you could support them. It's Anna Kimani. Reminding you, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe so that you can get notifications as I upload new videos. Follow me on my Facebook page, Excellence in Education Progress. I'm sharing a lot of resources there. And also visit my website, Anna G. Kimani Publications. There's a lot of resources there as well and some videos that you can learn from. Again, remember to give me some likes, they encourage me, and comments. Let me know which other areas that you'd want me to look at. For example, I was saying, I teach at Key Stages 3.5, and I got a request from parents with very young children that I need to address on how they could support young children, which I did today. And next video, I'll be sharing on numeracy. Today we look at reading and writing, which in UK we call literacy, the countries with English speaking background will be literacy. But I said I'm addressing the whole world, so it depends with which country you're coming from. And thank you for your time, and I look forward to meet you in the next session. Goodbye.